What are nitrates and what is an acceptable nitrate level in your aquaponics system? If you are new to this channel, my name is Jonathan and my aim is to help you to build your own aquaponics system and to manage it in the best way possible to grow some tasty, healthy and sustainable food in your own backyard thanks to aquaponics. So today we're going to talk about nitrates in aquaponics. So nitrates are very interesting particles because they can be considered as a pollution and as well they can be considered as a nutrient. For us in aquaponics, nitrates are going to be very important because they're going to be the source of food for the plant. But also if we got too much of them, at a certain level they're going to start to be toxic for the fish. So this is a molecule that we're going to test in the water. They are part of the water parameters that we're going to track and we're going to make sure that we maintain it in a good level. So basically when you feed your fish, the fish are going to poo and they're going to release some ammonia into the water. This ammonia is very toxic and it's going to be transformed thanks to some bacteria that we have in our grow bed in aquaponics into nitrites. Nitrites are even worse than ammonia. But then, thankfully, there are some other bacteria that are going to transform this nitrite into nitrate. And the nitrates, they are able to be absorbed by the plant. So now we got a nitrate that is the fertilizer for the plant, but very often in an aquaponic system, we don't have enough plants to absorb all the nitrates that are produced. So we need to test the water and to make sure that the nitrates are not building up in the setup, because you test your water after a few weeks of running the setup, the nitrates are going to be quite low. After a few months, if they increase a little bit every week, after a while, you know, they can reach a certain concentration. And every species of fish has got some limits into the quantity of nitrate that they can absorb, they can take, without having some bad or unwanted effects. What are those effects that they can have on fish? So a fish that is placed in a tank with a high concentration of nitrate, so nitrate levels that are above the maximum limit of the fish are going to start to change their behavior. You're going to find some that are going to swim very strangely. Some of them are going to start to swim on the surface, because the nitrates, basically, when the fish has got too much nitrate, it's going to stop the fish or it's going to decrease the capacity of the fish to transport the oxygen inside his body. So the fish are going to start to come on the surface and to try to breathe the oxygen of the air. If you see that and you know that you got a high concentration of oxygen in your water, it may be because you have too much nitrates in the water. So it's very important to check your nitrate levels. If it's for a long period of time, it can also have some anomaly into the shape of the fish. So you're going to have some fish with very strange tail, very strange body shape, and it can be due to the nitrate level. It will also affect your feed conversion ratio. So you know that when you feed your fish, you may put 1 kilo of fish food, and from this 1 kilo of fish food, which is dry, you may be able to produce, let's say, 1 kilo of fish, that is 80% moisture. Now, if you have high concentration of nitrate above the limit of the fish, well, with 1 kilo of fish food, you may be able to produce only 800 grams of fish. Basically, you're going to decrease the efficiency of the system, the efficiency of the ecosystem to produce some fish. So it has a significant impact on the productivity of the system. It can also affect the growth rate of your fish. So if the fish are able to reach the plate size in 1 year, maybe that if you got a high concentration of nitrates, it may take them 2 years to reach the plate size. So it's another effect of nitrates, the growth. And finally, if the fish are stressed due to high nitrate level, they're going to be way more likely to get any disease, because when a fish is stressed, the barrier against the disease are falling down. And that's where the fish is very, very highly exposed to disease. Finally, if the level is very, very high, the fish can simply die. So you see the importance to maintain low nitrate concentration. So when we talk about nitrogen levels, we are talking about ammonia, nitrite, and nitrate. Ammonia and nitrite are very toxic, but nitrate, the concentration that the fish can take is way higher. Now, this concentration is specific to every species. So in aquaculture, the fish farmers sometimes they keep the fish at very high level of nitrate if they add pure oxygen and those type of things. But in aquaponics, we don't want that at all. For trout, if you are above 100 ppm, you can start to see some problems. So it is recommended to keep it below 30 ppm. So 30 ppm is not much. Most of the plants, they enjoy a nitrate level that is around 30 ppm. From 10 to 30 is perfect for the plants. But for the fish, if you go above 30 ppm, then you can start to have some little problems. So most of the time, up to 100 ppm, you can't really see any real difference. But after 100 ppm, your fish are not going to be at ease and they may start to stress. And that's where you're going to have some troubles in your aquaponic system. You may have some fish that just get some disease and die. So really check your nitrate level. Now to check the nitrate level, very simple, you get a water test kit, so the same as for the aquarium. It's just some little bottles, you put some reactive inside and you can read the exact level of nitrate that you have in your system. It's very simple to do. I recommend to do it at the beginning once every week, and then you can do it a bit less often once you got some experience and you are used to your aquaponic system. But please don't leave the nitrate level to go to the roof, because it's going to be very painful for your fish. They're not going to be happy. So check it often, and if you see that the nitrate level are too high, there is a very simple solution to decrease it. Is to use this water to water your classic garden. If you use some water from your aquaponic system to water your classic garden, you're going to decrease the water level in your aquaponic system and you will have to add new water. And this new water is going to be zero in nitrates, rainwater or tap water, whatever you use. It's going to be very low in nitrates. So it's going to dilute the nitrate level of your aquaponic system. So now, if you are new to aquaponics and you need to know the different ratios that you respect, the different limits of the system when you breed the system, but also when you maintain it, I highly recommend you to get the free training in the description of this video just below. It's a free training, completely free, where you get all the critical information that you require, that you need to start aquaponics on good basis, but also to get some knowledge to manage the aquaponic system in the best way possible. So it's in the description of the video just below or in the corner of the video. If you are new to this channel, you can subscribe. I release one video every week, so it's a free tip to help you to breed and manage your aquaponic system in the best conditions. And if you like the video, please give it a like. It really helps me on YouTube to spread the information around the world. I see you in the next video. Bye bye. Don't forget to get your free gift from this screen. You can also leave me a comment below the video, subscribe to the channel, and see my last video. I really hope to see you soon. And I wish you a fantastic success with aquaponics. Have a good crop.